in the offensive zone. Zach Parise went through a little bit of a lull scoring goals, but last game, when they needed it, he had a hat trick in the first period against Calgary. But he is one of those guys, it's relentless, absolutely relentless around the net. He will do anything to help his team win. He can get down, he gets those ugly goals, those dirty goals, but those all-important goals for Minnesota Wild.
And you have a big game like you will see this afternoon. Leadership is so important. Let's talk about the captains for the respective teams. From Minnesota, Mikko Koivu. For the Avalanche, it's Gabe Landeskog.
And this has become a real rivalry. And you know, leaders of respective clubs love to play in big games. Gabe Landeskog knows how big this game is, and he knows he has to play an important role. Duchesne, MacKinnon, still out. He has to be that engine up front for the Colorado Avalanche. He has to do all the things that he needs to do for the Colorado Avalanche. And then on the other side, just as important for Minnesota, Mikko Koivu. Mike, and we've seen him for years now. He's now the franchise leader in games played for the Minnesota Wild. He's big, strong, tough. He is one of those, Mike, 200-foot center icemen that every good team has to have. He's good offensively, good defensively. He's strong, he's physical. So this is going to be another really important battle between these two captains.
For weeks, we've been looking forward to this game. And this afternoon, it is building to what we had hoped it would be. Everything on the line this afternoon. The Minnesota Wild, the Colorado Avalanche, a great rivalry has developed. And get set for the game of the season between Colorado and Minnesota. And you'll see it today on Altitude.
Maybe coming off his best game of the year. Last game, can he come up big here tonight? We sure hope so. Right now he's standing by with Mike Haines.
All right, thanks, Kyle. Well, John, with the injuries to both Duchesne and MacKinnon, your role has really increased. From my vantage point, it looks like it's going really well for you. How do you feel like it's going?
Yeah, I mean, I felt really good last game. I just want to continue that and play well tonight. So hopefully things will still happen the same way.
Four games already against Minnesota. You've learned about this Wild team. How do you beat them today?
Well, we just got to play hard. We got to play hard. We got to play physical. We got to get on that forecheck, force their D, you know, as quick as we can, and, you know, sustain pressure in the offensive zone.
All right. Well said. Have a great game, John. Thanks
for
your time.
Thanks, Mike.
All right. Back to you now, Kyle.
All right. Thanks, Mike. It doesn't get much bigger than this. The game of the year. It's the Avs and the Wild, and it's next on Altitude.
Pepsi Center in lower downtown Denver is filling up as we get set for the long-awaited game between the Minnesota Wild and the Colorado Avalanche. And let's take a look at today's Ford starting lineup. And Peter, it may come down to how these goaltenders play this afternoon.
Absolutely. Devin Dubnyk's last four games for the Minnesota Wild. In his last three home games, Semyon Varlamov has allowed just four goals. And Mike, you're absolutely right. In a game that will be this close, I mean, that's the way that you look at it. You got to think this is going to be a 2-1, 3-2 game. So every single save is going to be important.
We are set to go. Soderberg for the Avalanche. Koivu for Minnesota. And the puck is dropped, and here we go. We have waited a while for this one. The buildup has been big. And the Avalanche and the Minnesota Wild have begun play. Long pass for Sean Matthias. Pulls up, comes wide along the near side for the Avs. His shot off a leg, and the puck dribbles wide. Smacked to center ice by the Minnesota captain, Mikko Koivu. Nobody's played more games in a Minnesota Wild uniform than Koivu has. From behind the net, pass for John Mitchell. Strong game for the Avalanche against Philadelphia on that Thursday night, including a goal that put the Avs ahead in the third period. The puck is pushed ahead, and Varlamov comes out, and it bounced back towards him as he tried to clear. And Mitchell able to chip the puck to center ice. The first real dangerous situation. And Varlamov able to stop the puck after he came out of the net to get to it. Granlund stick handles his way in. Crafty player. Makes a nice pass. Backhand try. And blocked in front by Holden. Then a big hit by Holden on former Avalanche David Jones.
And Michael will look at the first sort of interesting play in this game. Puck is just chipped by Tyson Berrien. it pops up into the padding of Semyon Varlamov. But Michael, I'm telling you, this is going to be a physical game. Johnson on Parise right off the bat. Matthias, and Coyle were just jawing at each other right from the opening faceoff. Like this, there's no question. After that playoff series and all the games since, this is a two team fight and they just don't like each other.
Well, this is a legitimate rivalry.
Yep.
You're not just building up because of where it is in the standings, are we, Peter?
No.
These two teams don't get along.
No, absolutely. And Minnesota's had its way with the Avalanche up late, and that does not sit well with the Avalanche.
The Wild leading the season series this year. Avalanche are 1-3. This is the fifth and final game of the season between these two teams. Granlund centering pass back to the point. Bergen down low. Shot! Oh, and it was up in the air. Vanek was waiting right in front of the net. Suter shoots the puck around the boards. It circles to the near side. Tip to the corner. Bounce back behind the net. Up the wing for Botker. Lost the puck. Stripped away by Minnesota. Schrader puts the puck back in his own zone. Long pass ahead down the near side for Fontaine. Varlamov out of the net to play it around the wall. Chipped to center right. Scooped up with some speed by Skilly, but gets poke checked as he tried to dash his way to the front of the net. Staying with it is Skilly. Still up on his skates. Has the puck. Skilly to the point. Shot. Wow, that was a rocket that missed the net. And we see that physical play behind the Minnesota cage. Scandella with the puck, trying to clear, but Skilly with a nice play to get the glove on it. And the puck slips around. Brodin behind the net makes the pass. Scandella off the glass and backhanded out of the zone by the Wild. Fans get it back. Long pass. Landeskog onside. Bounces the puck towards Dubnyk, and he'll cover to get a faceoff in the Wild zone.
Well, Thomas Vanek, Mike, very interesting, returned to the lineup last game. Now, this is a guy that's, like, he's got 18 goals in his first 9 years in the National Hockey League, including the lockout year. He scored 20 goals. But he has been coach's decision four times in the last few games. You know, the three games in consecutive games before last game and getting back into the lineup. So it's an interesting, you know, decision to, you know, to bench a guy or to hold out a guy that can score as well as he can.
Back in and had a scoring chance, but did not deliver. As Varlamov puts the puck over the net. Crazy pass cut off behind the cage by Boschman. Gets in by Spurgeon. Tipped between the circles. Smacked to center ice by Boschman. Out to center. Tipped along the boards and Koivu. Nailed it right back into the Avalanche zone. That's wearing their third sweater. And this is a team that has won their last two games wearing the sweater. Brought him a little bit of luck the past couple of contests. They've worn them. Running by Matthias. Into the corner. Gets bumped. Stays with the puck. Trying to make a handoff behind the net. Granlund, though, chipped it away. And Suter gliding in the corner with the Ginla. And Granlund took away the puck. He's got a couple of Avalanche players on him. Pass out in front. And it just eluded John Mitchell. Pass tipped into the Av zone. Mitchell. Off the board, stolen back by Vanek. His pass kicked by Barry to center ice, sent back into the Minnesota zone. Mike Riley, cross ice pass, and thrown out towards center ice by Dumba of Minnesota. Lifts right back to center ice, and Matt Dumba. Quick pass, slides in around the boards in the Colorado zone. Looked around the boards, a nice tip pass by Como. Gets it up ice for Botker. Cutting in wide, he shoots wide of goaltender Devin Dubnyk. Then Como reverses the puck around. Hit by Botker. Dumba. Wouldn't clear it up the boards. Comes behind the net and Riley. Bounce pass up the wall towards Niederreiter. Gets away and comes all the way down to the side of the Avalanche net where Varlamov will leave it there for Chris Bigras to take. Young defenseman to center ice, makes a pass through the middle for Grigorenko. It bounced. Botker kicks the puck ahead off the wall. And it knocked away by Grigorenko. Skates behind the Minnesota net, gets shoved into the boards, and no call was made. The puck freed up, carried behind the net by Brodin. Peter, you made a comment in the last game against Philadelphia. There was an early penalty for hitting on the hands. The shot stopped by Varlamov. We'll see what kind of a game the referees are going to allow today, this afternoon.
Mike, if there's an early game plan for the Avalanche, they are going to be physical in this game. We're talking about controlled emotion. You know, it's one thing, Mike, to go out there and run around, taking the big hit, but then taking a penalty. You can't afford to do that. The Minnesota Wild power play is on fire right now. Four power play goals in the last two games, three last game against Calgary. So, you know, look for the Avalanche. Continue what they're doing right now, but you can't push it too far.
Soderberg taking the face off for the Avalanche. And Koivu wins the draw back to the point. Suter shoots and misses the net. Still on the boards, Parisi. Coming off a hat trick and a 4-point performance against Calgary. Soderberg couldn't get out of the zone with the puck. Koivu passing the slot, but Koivu had his stick being held and couldn't receive the pass. Cut down the boards by Soderberg back into the Minnesota zone. Pass in front of the net. Went off the boards for Koivu. Makes the pass out to center and is tipped by Parisi into the Colorado end. Varlamov sets it behind the net. Go ahead, Peter.
Mike, I was just going to say, it may not be a big point, but this is the earliest that this place has been full of any of the games I've seen this year.
Shot wide by Mitchell. Pass out in front of the net. Chance, shot, blah! Save made by Dubnyk with Mitchell standing right in front of them. Scandella and Mitchell start shoving. Aguila jumps into the pile as well. Oh, there's some anger on the ice. Big time game, big time feelings here in this first period. Mitchell and Scandella showing how everybody's feeling.
To center with Patrick Roy. And Patrick, you know how close this game is probably going to be and where the two teams are in the standings. Is this the kind of start that you expected?
Yes. I mean, it's going to be a close game. I thought everybody would want to play well defensively, get some forecheck going. There's a lot of puck deep. Both teams want to establish their forecheck, have some couple of good hits here and there, and then I think that set the tone.
Thanks, Patrick.
You're welcome.
Okay, guys, back up to you.
Thank you very much, Julian. As always, we appreciate head coach Patrick Roy being available to make his comments as we get set for a face-off in the Minnesota zone. Wild win another draw. Rodin able to chip it up, but didn't get it out. Avalanche got a chance. Shot looking for a tip in front. Grigorenko was trying to set up Como, but it went wide. Long shot, and Varlamov makes the save and then the cover. Let's take a look at today's winning combo presented by Blackjack Pizza.
But stop Parisi. His numbers against the Avalanche have been, as they are against the Bulls clubs, excellent. And special teams. Mike, it's one of those situations now where this game, nobody's going to give anything away. You can feel as they're coming off, the shifts have been short. They've been very, very precise. The guys on the bench are very aware there hasn't been any miscommunication. So you know it's going to be a tight game. So especially teams, that one power play goal for or against could be so key.
Mikko Rantanen wins a faceoff in his own zone. Nice draw there by Rantanen. Gets it up ice and McLeod. Rantanen going to the front of the net and the puck sail wide. Back up the wing and Rantanen swings it around back to the far side. Riley swished against the boards. The puck comes free. Chased down by Dumba, quick outlet pass, and a big bang and hit by Holden. And Holden has the puck. Ripped away from him, and then a hit by McLeod frees up the puck again. Shot from the point, glove saved by Dubnyk, and then McLeod going after Mike Riley. Boy, a couple of big hits, but it began with Nick Holden with a huge collision at the blue line.
Nick Holden has done this all season long. He is now over 200 hits this season. And Cody McLeod, you know what he's going to bring every night. This is how he plays the game. Good, hard work along the boards. Driving to the front of the net, that's where he's going to want to be. But Holden, Mike, has just had an outstanding season for the Colorado Avalanche. Mike, he's only the, since 2005, 2006, when they started counting block shots as a statistic, Mike, he's only the 27th player, or it's only the 27th time that somebody's had 200 hits, 100 block shots, and 20 points.
Well, he's had two big hits already in this game. Both have been on David Jones. A strong play, 7 minutes into the first period. Avalanche with 9 hits to Minnesota's 2. So the Avalanche have come out and they've been more physical, at least registering more hits than Minnesota has in this first period. Coyle for Minnesota. Puck back in. Good forecheck by Colorado. Landeskog chasing the puck. A quick pass out to center. Habs get it back. Mathias turns the puck across for Boschman. Tipped in the air. Bouncing. Slugged back up the wing and then brought in offside by Colorado. We check in ringside with Julie Brownman.
Hey guys, before the Philly game, the Avs locker room very loose, a lot of smiles on their faces. Well, after that loss to Philly and yesterday in the locker room, very tight-lipped, very serious, a different move. Players said, even telling us, this is a must-win. Patrick Roy held his team meeting yesterday. He told the guys, go home and not look at the big picture, because if you look at the big picture, it's going to be scary. Just look at this one game and be ready to go from the first period. Guys.
Thank you, Julie. Faceoff in the neutral zone, following the offside by the Avalanche. Colorado winning the faceoff, hammered in around the wall by Nick Coleman. And then shot down the ice, wave off the icing. Redmond coming back for the puck. Bouncing on him. Fontaine blocked it, then gets run over by Redmond, who makes a pass for Martinson. He goes cross ice for Ginla. Back in front. Tipped by Mitchell, but Dubnyk makes the save. All right, let's check in now. Lauren Gardner. Lauren?
Well, Mike, earlier Julie just talked about the very somber and almost serious tone at Avs practice yesterday. And for the Wild, it's almost the exact opposite. In a brief conversation that I had with Minnesota head coach Don Torchetti, he said that his team is loose. They're relaxed. They're having a good time. And while today's game is very important, it is not an absolute must win, Mike. In fact, he said those absolute must wins will come closer towards the end of the season, more likely those last two games.
All right, we're going to start getting into it mathematically. Back to the point, shot on a skip, and Dubnyk is able to make the save.
Well, Francois Boschman continues just to have an outstanding season for the Avalanche. He is that settling force for the Avs. He's that veteran of all the Avalanche defensemen, all the Avalanche players. He's been through the most of these kind of games, Mike. These are the kind of games that he relishes. When he was in Anaheim, he was that go-to guy as far as minutes and performance.
Avs have won 4 straight faceoffs. They lost that one as Minnesota able to send the puck out to center ice. Shot down low. Kick save by Dubnyk on Bodker, who walked in between the circles. Avalanche starting to spend a little bit of time in that Minnesota zone. Now out shooting the Wild 6-3. They've outshot them now the last 5 shots. The Avs have had 4 of them that have been on net. Buck easy in the Colorado zone. Poppenville. Buck 3 behind the net. Squirts loose. Bodker makes the pass to center ice for Como. Backhands it in. Scandella back for Minnesota. Lose the puck, set it out in front. Up the slide, and a chance. Missed wide. Oh, what a golden opportunity there for the Avalanche. Puck is tipped in, offside Minnesota.
Now, Michael, it started on the first shift. It started with Coyle and Mathias talking to each other before he even dropped the first puck. And Michael, I'm standing in a bad spot right here. There have been at least 4 times so far where players have been coming off the ice and they just have been exchanging words, comments, sticks, hits. And again, it's, you love this kind of game, but you don't want to be that guy that takes that first penalty. You can feel it, can't you, Michael?
It's palpable.
It is.
Here in Pepsi Center.
You can't explain it unless you feel it. It's an amazing sensation. A big game with a lot on the line.
And for the Avalanche, who did not make the playoffs last year, an opportunity this season to get into the playoffs, but they're going to need some big, big wins. 8 games left, 3 points behind Minnesota, who has that second playoff spot. Parisi, backhand set, there's a chance, and diving! The puck was tipped away by Eric Johnson. Eric Johnson, what a super play there from the big defenseman.
Did you see that, Michael? Did you see what Semyon Varlamov just did? He came straight out at Eric Johnson. You watch the play. This is what Parisi does so well. All the way down the ice, little backhand. But watch Johnson. Ben, he goes down. And Semyon Varlamov might came 30 feet out of his net to pat him on the rear end. He just took that one right off the back.
Off in the neutral zone. Minnesota Spurgeon sends the puck across for Ryan Suter. He is going to get monster minutes this afternoon. He plays a ton for this Minnesota Wild team. Montaigne's going to get a penalty. He jumped on the back of Redmond. First penalty's going to be on Minnesota. Delay call. Wild touch the puck, and the Avalanche get the first power play chance. Justin Fontaine just simply jumped on the back of Zach Redmond. And there's your first penalty. Peter, you talked about that first penalty of the game. He did not want to be that guy going to the box, and Fontaine is that guy.
And here's where the Avalanche can set the tone. You take a penalty 200 feet from your own net, and you know, Mike, coaches hate those as much as they hate any type of penalty. The long distance penalty where you're really not affecting the play. And now the Avalanche, the place is bubbling. They've been getting some good momentum. They want to move the puck around and have good movement away from the puck.
And this is a Minnesota team, one of the worst penalty killing teams in the National Hockey League. Ranked 27th overall this year, killing penalties. But the Wild get the puck after the draw. They rifle down the ice as Fontaine begins to serve his 2-minute minor penalty for holding. It was called at 9:51. And the Avalanche on the power play, first power play chance. And they've been good this year against Minnesota. 3-for-7 this year for Colorado. Bouncing puck, slugged to center by Holland. Tyson Barrie back to get it for the Avalanche. Finds a seam, gets his way into the zone. One-handed behind the net. Brodin tipped it up the boards, but Landeskog was waiting. Shot back across. Soderberg first to the puck for the Avalanche. Shot up and out by Minnesota.
Good start to the penalty kill, Mike, for Minnesota. They've done a real nice job.
Statistically, they have not been good this season overall against the NHL, nor against the Avalanche. Halfway through that Fontaine penalty. Shot around by Beauchemin. Tip, knocked down, played behind the net for Como for Colorado. His pass went off the glass, bounced past Beauchemin, and he hustles. Stoll doing the forechecking for Minnesota, turns away to go to the bench. Carried up ice by Johnson. Checked as he came to the line. And the puck smashed back the other way and a long hop. 25 seconds left in Fontaine's penalty. Beauchemin makes the pass up ice. Carried in offside by Colorado. Today's game being brought to you in part by Kia. Visit ColoradoKiaDealers.com to discover Kia's full lineup of high quality, stylish, and dependable vehicles.
Well, the third line change for the Avalanche on this power play. Patrick Waugh looking for a little bit of bite on this power play in the last 18 seconds. You always got to figure the man coming from the box into the play. And it takes about 5 seconds. So you got, Mike, you still have time on this power play.
Asking Jerome McGinley to win the faceoff, but Minnesota gets to it. And the puck, a clear deep. Barrie gets a hold of it. And rims it around into the Wild zone. Put off in the corner. Up to the half boards on a bounce. Pulled in. The pitchforks it back towards the corner. Out of the box comes Fontaine. So the first power play of the afternoon. And the Avalanche did not manage a single shot on net in that 2-minute power play. from center, shot in by Holman. So we are still scoreless here in this first period. Puck in the Minnesota zone. Studer around the shelf, backing up. Johnson rimmed it back behind the net, cut off by the goaltender Devin Dubnyk. Went around the wing for Spurgeon to take. Minnesota, long pass, kicked off of Boschman. Scooped up by Como. Plays it back into the Colorado zone. Bodker picks up the puck and with speed. The center ice, Johnson over the line, nice passing. Bodker skates to the corner with the puck, still with it, trying to center. Bodker still battling for the puck, rolled it behind the Minnesota net. Quick pass to center ice, Minnesota on the move. They get in over the line, taken by Hulla, but the Wild are offside. Downtown Denver, a little dusting of snow this morning. See who is in the groove, presented by Groove Subaru and Zach Parise, who does a lot of good things for this team offensively. Peter, he's in the groove right now.
He's one of those players it's almost impossible not to like. I mean, you hate him because he does so well against the Avalanche, but you love how he does it. There's nothing cheap, there's nothing on the outside, it's all hard work. Tremendously skilled player. But more importantly, Mike, he pays the price. He and Johnson are having a battle today. They've already been yapping at each other. They're already, you know, a little stick, a little bang here and there.
Parise leads his team in shots, goals, and game-winning goals. He's got six of them this year. Jones pushed the puck ahead. The defenseman Dumba backhands it across the wide. Granlund couldn't hold the puck. Played up the wing for Holden. Bannock turns and shoots. Save made by Varlamov.
I'd hate to bring up bad memories, but back to game one for the Colorado Avalanche. The Avs are up this one 4-1. And Zach Parise led a comeback for the Minnesota Wild. A 5-4 victory. The last one coming on the power play for the Avalanche. And like the one, there was one play that we didn't show where he got rocked by Landeskog. Hit as hard as you could get hit. Jumped up, went to the front of the net, and punched one home. I mean, he is just that kind of player. And again, you're going to hate him if you're an Avalanche fan, and you should, because he does so much. But you respect how he plays this game.
Koivu against Soderberg. Shots are even at six. Avs have had a power play in this game. Breezy shoots, but a lot of Avs in the way, and the puck was deflected. Spurgeon moves the puck up off the boards. Back into the Colorado zone. Eric Johnson. What a game he had on Thursday against Philadelphia. Nine shots, career best. He said after the game, that may have been the best game he's played in his career. Mathias pass in front, blocked. And pushed away by Suter. And out to center ice, off of Coyle. Boschman's pass to Soderberg. Blocked at the Minnesota line. And swatted the other direction, long enough to draw an icing call.
Thanks for the Colorado Avalanche, the one. Right in the trade deadline, they made a trade for Bodker, and he has played so well. And I think the important thing, you see the 3 goals, 5 assists, and 10 points, but he's had points in 7 games, Mike. And almost as important as the numbers, it's how many in the game. In 7 games, he's had an impact. And you know the Avalanche right now are struggling to get goals inside of any game, and he's been so important to their success.
And then you can add, Peter, he had the game winner in that shootout against Calgary.
And the game winner in the Vancouver game, the second goal in a 3-1 win.
Up from center ice by Vanek. Vanek gives chase. He and Holden collide behind the net. Vanek, nice play to kick it free. The shot to save made by Varlamov. And the puck comes up the boards. Hooked out to center ice by McLeod for Colorado. Riley backing up into his own zone. Looks to make a pass. Bounced it. Stolen back by Skilly. Lobbed in. Hammered off the board, but a nice play again by Skilly. Shoots, saved by Dubnyk, and dashing after the puck. Rantanen centered in the slot, poked away, pinching in. Boschman keeps it in the Minnesota zone. Rantanen pushed off the puck. Sports back behind the net. Riley took it from Minnesota. Quick pass to center ice. Brought in onside by Minnesota. Shot tipped. Out of play by Redmond. The pair of 22s there, Niederreiter and Redmond. Pushing and shove a little bit. Did you know? Presented by Stevenson Automotive. Here's today's question. Which player has the fastest fastest hat trick in NHL history. Was it A, Bill Mozienko, B, Mario Lemieux, C, Gordie Howe? If you'd like to play, open up the Avalanche mobile app, click on Did You Know Trivia, and one lucky fan will win a pair of tickets to an upcoming game. Stevenson, 10 great brands, 7 locations. We'll have an answer for you in the third period. Face off in the Colorado zone. Few seconds, over 5 minutes remaining in the first period. No score, 8-7 shot advantage for Colorado. After also leading another category, pretty impressive, 14-4 in terms of hits. Mitchell, 2-on-1, blast one, what a save by Dubnyk.
Michael, it didn't seem like a big trade at the time. Last year, Devin Dubnyk comes over from Arizona to the Minnesota Wild. The Minnesota Wild were stumbling. They couldn't find any traction in their season. Like, this is the 100th game now that he has played for the Minnesota Wild, and he has been tremendous. They got into the playoffs last year because he played so well.
He's won his last 4, 9-1-1 in his last 11 decisions. He went through a stretch, though, earlier, Peter, where he went through 9 games where he couldn't come up with a win. But he's playing well right now. Just made a tremendous glove save on Mitchell. Martinson had the puck pushed away from him, bouncing at the Colorado line. Coming up, Holden, his pass. Shoots pass to Gittle. Gittle after the puck in the corner. Bends off a check. Pass to Boschman. Slides it across. Johnson just on the ice. His shot gets blocked. But an angled across, and Boschman got to watch as Parisi picks up the puck. Parisi threw it back to the point. Spurgeon, nice play at the blue line to keep it in. Sacrificed the body by getting blown up by Landeskog. On a hit. Handoff goes. Far side. Given towards Parisi. Pass back to Spurgeon. Up high for Suter. Down low. Pass in front. And a kick parade. And swatted at and blocked by Boschman. And tipped out to center ice. Best offensive thrust there for Minnesota this first period. Ryan Suter, long pass, tipped in by Schrader. Harlamov leaves it behind the net. Barry back behind the net, gets the pass. Starting to head out to center ice. Schrader trying to tie him up. And the puck bounced off of Soderberg. One-handed back for Holden. Bounce to center, shoots past Mathias, no icing. And Dubnyk will set the puck for Scandella to take. Being chased by Mathias. And the pass tipped through the center circle. Holden gets it across for Tyson Barron, the Avs defenseman. Get it back and forth. Holden now with the puck. Lead pass to center, gathered in by Grigorenko. Nice pass to Bodker. He shoots off the Minnesota skate. Bodker along the boards with the puck. Poked at. Cleared to center by the Wild. Bigrov sends the puck across. Shot in from center ice by Johnson. Pass to the side of the net. Scandella coughed it up. Grigorenko's got a man in front. Bodker. Grigorenko fights off the check. To Como. Tipped away. Bigrov pinches in. Trying to make a pass. Scandella turned it off the boards and got it out of the zone.
I just stopped him to watch Bodker. He is really winding up. He's going deep, and he's giving the defenseman a real outlet, but with speed.
Pushed ahead, Skilly coming in with speed, coming wide, he shoots. A tip by Riley, and a bounce comes for the Avalanche. Skilly again with the puck, he shoots wide of the net. Niederreiter, he gets clobbered, and the puck comes free. The Avalanche with those hits are freeing up the puck. Rantanen to the point, Boschman. To Barry, he shoots, misses. Shot by Rantanen, got tipped up into the crowd and out of play. These lucky fans were upgraded from the Ram Trucks fan zone to lower bowl seats, courtesy of Ram Trucks. Purchase tickets in section 362 for your chance to win. Upgrade to the official truck of your Colorado Avalanche.
Here's that last little flurry by this fourth line for the Colorado Avalanche. Good work down low, good speed for the Avalanche. So, Mike, Minnesota couldn't make a change they wanted to make. And so right now the Avalanche, they were trying to get a different line on the ice. They couldn't get it on the ice. The referee had his hand up. So the Avalanche, let's see how this works.
Mitchell is trying to win the faceoff against Eric Halla. And Mitchell wins it. Got it to Ginla. Circles down the boards. Pass behind the net from Martinson. Mitchell set up in front. Wanted the pass. He gets one in front. But Dubnyk took it away. Boy, as Martinson was circling behind the net, Mitchell was pounding the ice. Wanted that pass.
And again, watch Barry on the far side. And the Avalanche offside defensemen have been very active. Barry sliding down. Johnson slid down. Holden has been sliding down. And again, the Avalanche, when they're aggressive like this with their defensemen, that's when they seem to be on top of their game.
Johnson and Boschman remain out for the Avalanche. Landeskog trying to win a faceoff against Koivu. Comes free to the corner. Landeskog zipped it back to the point. Johnson down the boards. One-handed behind the net. The Avalanche are racing after the puck and winning a lot of one-on-one battles. And really pushing, putting that pressure on Minnesota. Back in from center ice by Koivu into the half zone. 1:15 remaining. And changing up their forward line. Bodker, Grigorenko, and Komo are out. Jones tipped the puck in. Boschman off the boards. Komo center ice for Bodker. Coming in, fakes, then shoots, head high, gloved by Dubnyk. Be a part of the Avalanche family by investing in a season membership today. Members receive benefits like playoff priority, access to the annual Meet the Team party, and so much more. Call 303-4-AVS-NHL or visit ColoradoAvalanche.com. Another face-off for the Minnesota zone. Avs are now leading in shots 11-7. And pushing the play and bottling up the Wild in their own zone. While they've not had too many offensive thrusts here in this first period, where they've had the puck for a long time in the Avalanche end. Bodker puts it around. Avs doing a nice job. If they have the puck in their own zone, they're getting it out quick, and they do it again. Pass to center ice for Bigra. Skates in. Grigorenko, long shot, and another glove save by Dubnyk.
It's interesting to watch Dubnyk, Mike. And from up where you sit, yeah, I think we see one thing up there. From down here, it's really apparent he uses his glove hand really well. But what he does, Mike, he is so tall. He's 6'6". He'll go down on his knees, but his shoulders are square right underneath the crossbar. So there's very little to shoot at, and he gets the glove out, high, and it's ready to catch almost everything.
Well, he made a sensational glove save on Mitchell earlier. Mitchell's out again for the faceoff. Vaughn Rohde, the linesman, dropping the puck. Mitchell won another draw. Boschman slapped it across. Martinson working his way along the board, showing how strong he is. Centered, and a pinball to around some skates. Quickly to center ice. Minnesota on the move. Pominville, long shot to the corner. Paula behind the net for Pominville. Puck scooped up. Spurgeon receives the pass. He shoots, missed the net. Comes around far side. Suter got there in time. Shoots at the buzzer. As we come to the end of our first period of play. Well, the Avalanche had several good spurts of offensive pressure. Varlamov made his saves, but so did Dubnyk, Peter.
Yeah, that was, Mike, that's hockey at its best as far as the intensity. The Avalanche got in front of every Minnesota Wild player that had the puck. They made them make a play, and then they played the body. And that's what the Avalanche want to do. It's not a first period thing. It's a third period thing where you start to wear a team down.
Into 20 minutes, one period in the books here at Pepsi Center in Denver, Colorado. You're watching Avalanche Hockey on Altitude Sports. No score after one. Stay tuned. Coming up next is the Subaru Intermission Report. The Avalanche in the Wild. We go to the second period. It is a scoreless game. in the biggest game of the season so far for the Avalanche and the Wild. And let's take a look at our Lexus on the ice and why the Avalanche, Peter, they feel like they have been pressuring the Wild throughout this game so far.
Yeah, and they're using their speed. And another thing down here again, Mike, this is the first time I've been down here with this group as far as Colorado Avalanche. And it is a bigger group. And size and speed are going to back you up. You just can't stand there where Mathias, Martinson, Johnson, Soderberg, Landeskog are coming into the zone. Remember, they're coming with a lot of speed. And Johnny Mitchell, the last game and this game, Mike, is absolutely terrific. He had three shots on goal in the first period for the Avalanche. And his line, and Patrick Waugh had him out there for the big faceoff. He was last game against Philadelphia, big game, 12-5 in faceoffs. And you knew without MacKinnon and Duchesne, there's going to be a situation where they're going to need somebody to step up. And he's done a terrific job.
And we begin the second period. Avalanche had 11 different players that registered a hit in the first period. Parisi trying to settle the puck down for Minnesota in the Avalanche zone. Wild didn't spend a lot of time in the Avs end during that first period. It did muster 8 shots, but not too many great scoring chances for Minnesota. And here's an opportunity for the Avalanche. Mathias one-on-one with Suter. Takes the long shot. Dubnyk kicked the puck to the corner. Mathias out-dueled Suter to it. And Landeskog gets pushed against the boards. And Coyle moves the puck to center. Pass to the trailer, Vanek shoots, and a stick save made by Varlamov. Puck clear to the center. Flag down to by Granlund. Steps around Soderberg, makes the pass up ice for David Jones. Homer Ab was acquired from Calgary, trade deadline time. And the puck lifted out to center. Bodker, nice job of protecting the puck. Able then to backhand it into the Minnesota end. Wild have won 4 games in a row. Have won 3 of the last 4. The loss was on Thursday night here at home to the Philadelphia Flyers. A 4-2 loss. Well, that night, Minnesota, 6-2 win for Calgary. Shot, and that one skimmed wide of the net. Holden for the Avalanche. Put the puck behind his own net. Had just one penalty called. It's been a physical game, but just one penalty that went against Minnesota. Grigorenko circling the Wild net. Still in possession. A couple of players on him. Worked it behind the net, tipped in the corner, but the Avalanche get to the puck first. Martinson powering his way along. Threw it off the side of the Minnesota net. Quick pass. Niederreiter run at by Mitchell, but the puck taken by Holland. Skates over the line. Makes the pass, but behind the defenseman Dumba. And Mitchell, boy, he's been just terrific. Filling in Matt Duchesne with that knee injury. And Mitchell has been a big, big player for the Avalanche since replacing Matt Duchesne on that line. Backhanded across to the red line. Dumped in, glove high, caught by Varlamov, keeps the play going. Kinla tips the puck from the red line. They're going to say he didn't quite cross the red line when he tipped the puck, so the Avs are called for icing.
Well, guys, yesterday Patrick Waugh told his team, go home, rest, and be ready for this game as soon as it starts. Now, I talked to Patrick right in between the first period. He said he was very happy with how his team responded physically and aggressively, which is good because in the first period, the Wild outscored their opponents by 10 goals, so they weathered that storm. Patrick Waugh is thrilled with his team's performance in the first, guys.
All right, thanks, Julie. Face off in the Avalanche zone. Mitchell, Koivu, two very good centermen on faceoffs as the Avalanche should come up with the puck. Long shot, blocker save made by Dubnyk on Iginla. Minnesota coming out to center. Suter smashes the puck in, comes up the boards, shot goes high, may have been tipped. Up the wing, and the Avalanche first to the puck, Mathias. Makes the patient play, gets it to Boschman, got it back to Mathias. Shoots it in, Dubnyk. Got Soderberg coming behind him, but of course the puck to Suter, and banked it, Spurgeon. Up to the center, but the Avalanche right on the puck. Johnson takes it for Colorado. Long shot. Dubnyk makes the save. Big juicy rebound. And the shot comes to the side of the net. Into the corner. Landeskog. The Boschman. Sent across for Johnson. Shot. Missed on the short side. Landeskog. Lifting by Redmond. Sent around behind the net. Mathias. Nice move to cut out in front. Still with the puck. Back to the point. Good puck movement by the Avalanche. Redmond, shot, stick save, another big rebound off of Dubnyk. And the puck is cleared out by Minnesota. Great pressure there from the Avalanche. Puck comes out through center ice. Skilly, first to it. Avalanche win a lot of battles to the puck. Brandon shoots, and the save made by Dubnyk. All right, let's check in. Here is Lauren Gardner. Lauren?
Well, Mike, you guys have talked about the physical play in the first period, and that's exactly what Minnesota's Jarrett Stoll addressed during that last intermission. He said, we have to take advantage of the way the Avs are playing. We know what's coming. We need to talk both on the ice and on the bench and make smart plays around that. Ultimately said he's not going to change the way that they play their game.
All right, thank you, Lauren. Here in this period, Colorado with five shots, Minnesota with four. And the Avs winning another faceoff. Skilly in the corner, Scandella separates him from the puck. Banged out to center ice. But a hand pass has been called, so we'll have another faceoff.
Well, everybody knows this is the big game, but let's look at some of the facts surrounding it. Minnesota played one more game than the Avalanche, so the Avalanche have a game in hand. Points obviously favor the Minnesota Wild. They're 3 points ahead of the Avalanche. Mike, the first tiebreaker is the one in the middle, Rose. Regulation overtime wins. The Avalanche have one more of those.
Avalanche step up, it is Rantanen and shooting. Save, rebound, shot goes wide by Skilly. And the Avalanche putting that pressure on Minnesota as stop, rush through the middle by the Wild. Played off the boards, tipped in by Colorado. Dumba slams the puck around, and it hit Holden, who was going off the ice. And so they stopped the play because of that.
Here's that last effort. And Mike Rantanen looks a lot more comfortable today. You know, you knew when he got called up, and he was going to, you know, play limited minutes on that fourth line for the Avalanche after being used to playing a lot in the American Hockey League. Like, you have to adjust to the idea that you're getting 3-4 shifts a period, not 10-11 per period. So, you know, it's just a little bit of the learning curve for Rantanen and Mike, who, you know, he is going to be a player. I've watched him in warm-up, but I've watched him.
Tenth overall pick. There you see Cody McLeod getting a little medical attention. Scott Woodward, terrific trainer for the Avalanche, working with Cody McLeod. Shot wide of Varlamov. Minnesota called for icing.
Talking to Cody McLeod before tonight's game, and you know, he's one of those guys that met Mike maybe earlier in his career, in his ninth year now at the Avalanche. Maybe he takes a little bit, he gets a little too wound up. He's learned how to really control it. I mean, you can actually talk to him, you know, now. And within years, in the first few years, boy, I mean, he was so wild. But he's really become a true professional for the Avalanche.
And chance to the side of the net. Suter was trying to play it behind the net, but it hit the side. And gave the Avalanche a chance to get to the puck. Grigorenko walks in, he shoots, and Dubnyk makes the save. Cooney Lexus of Greenwood Village, Colorado's favorite Lexus dealer, invites you to see the full line of Lexus all-weather drive sedans and luxury utility vehicles. Visit Cooney Lexus of Greenwood Village at I-25 in Bellevue or online.
I was talking to some of the Avalanche players. They're well aware. This is a well-balanced Minnesota club. Like, they have 12 guys with 10-plus goals. That's the most in the National Hockey League. So the scoring is blended through the entire lineup.
Another win by the Avs in the faceoff in the Minnesota zone. Shot goes wide. Brodin took away the puck, got it to Coyle. Quick pass to center for Parisi. The cross. And there was a collision at the blue line involving Parisi and caused the play to be offside. Then Coyle and Landeskog start to get angry with each other. Let's watch again as this puck is brought over the line, end up being offside.
Parise was trying to stay, like, onside, and Landeskog said, no, you're not going to stay onside. But again, I heard Mark Rycroft talking about it. This is not a dirty, awful play, but this is the kind of play that wears you out. If, you know, you keep getting hit time after time after time. After a while, you know, at altitude, it doesn't matter. You are going to feel it. And the Minnesota Wild, Mike, they're working the ref right now. I mean, they're all talking to the referees.
They have not had a power play in this game. They haven't had the only man advantage. But squirts to center. Suter got the angle, got to it, but he gave it away. Dragged in down the wall by Mathias. Centers in the slot, pass across, top of the circle, Johnson shoots, missed on the short side. Coyle. Boy, the Avalanche not letting Minnesota get through the neutral zone at all. Got back in. We saw remnants of this against Philadelphia on Thursday. The Avalanche just kept that pressure on the Flyers.
Somewhere in that second period, it stopped for the Avalanche. It has not stopped here tonight.
Stopped right after they scored, Peter. Dillon shoots, save. And there's going to be a penalty on Minnesota. So the Avs are going to get another power play opportunity. And Ryan Suter is going to the penalty box. And John Mitchell and the Avs. Let's look at today's Coors Light cold hard facts. And we look at the schedule and what games are left this season for both teams. Peter?
Yeah, for Minnesota, four home, two on the road. For the Colorado Avalanche, three at home, four on the road, including the next two, Mike. And these ones are going to be tough. Nashville has now had recorded a point in 18 of the last 20 games they've played. They mean they've only lost twice in regulation in the last 20. And St. Louis is on fire. They've caught Dallas now, and both of them are tied atop the Central Division with 97 points.
Remember, that game is the second of back-to-back.
Yes.
For the Avs. Power play chance, though, for Colorado. They win the faceoff. And around behind the net, bouncing puck. Second power play chance of the game for Colorado. Scoreless second period. Penalty called on Ryan Suter. Not only does Minnesota have a shorthanded situation, but they lose their best defenseman, Ryan Suter, who'd certainly be out there quite a bit on this penalty kill. Back to the point. Slid across for Grigorenko. Barry trying to get some room. Makes a nice pass. Shot off the stick, I think.
Yep.
Of Dubnyk. Another one. Timer missed. Wide of the net, and Ginlett was set up for it. Grigorenko to Barry. Grigorenko moving through the faceoff circle. Ginlett's wide open. The far faceoff circle. Grigorenko. Side of the net, there's a chance, stopped by Dumic, and he covers the puck with Mathias right there in the crease.
And he had Mathias, who came over on a trade from the Toronto Maple Leafs, like getting more and more important minutes. He's already on a huge line for the Avalanche. I mean, not just physically huge, but a big minutes line for the Avalanche with Soderberg and Landeskog. But now, that first power play unit, and right in front of the net, and he just missed. Finding a Ginla on that far side.
Another faceoff in the Minnesota zone. And the Avalanche cannot get that one. Koivu gets the puck himself after he took the faceoff and shoots it into the Colorado end. Eric Johnson dropped it to the trailer. Botker weaves his way in. Got poke check, but followed up by Como and Fontaine. A little help. And the puck cleared out by Minnesota. Boschman.
Their numbers might be bad, but they have been good on the two penalty kills today.
Coming right down the middle. Landeskog sends it across for Botker. Forced to out of the zone. A race for the puck. And a chance for Parise. Shorthanded. Big save by Varlamov. Save by Semyon Varlamov. Oh, the Avs needed that one. They got it. And Parise coming in shorthanded. Kelly is over. Suter's out of the box. Gives the puck to Parise. He's shoots in the sink. Has him front. Save again by Varlamov. But was the net moved?
No, it's a penalty.
Or a penalty.
It's going to be a penalty. This is Zach Parise, Mike, at his best. Look at him work. He's fighting off two guys, comes in, and Mike, there's good saves and there's big saves. And that was both for Semyon Varlamov. Look at that. Look at that effort. As we said to Mike early, you can hate him because he's on another club, but boy, you got to like him for the way that he plays the game. Good work by the Avalanche down low. Here's that shot. And Mike, that would have been a tough one, shorthanded, to have that one come, you know, have Parise score on that one. So Semyon Varlamov really makes a big save.
The penalty is on Chris Bigras. He knocked down Granlin there at the side of the net. Slashing penalty at 8:15. And Minnesota gets their first power play opportunity of the game. They are led by Koivu, who has 10 power play goals this season. Wild win the faceoff. Wild not been good against the Avalanche this season. Just 1 for 11. Here's a steal. Como one-on-one with Riley. Cuts in. Still with the puck. Pass out in front. Granlin stole it from Mitchell. Niederreiter for the trailer. Dumba pushes across for Granlin. Kyle Granlin back to Dumba. Minnesota on their first power play chance of the game. Riley shoots through traffic. Save made. And the rebound kicks to the corner. Granlin for the Wild. Side of the net for Niederreiter. Back to Granlin. Pass shot by Vanek. Save. Rebound comes to the Avs and cleared out. Oh, Varlamov is looking sharp here. This second period, he has been tested.
Vanek was in a perfect spot. He's a goal scorer, and he just was blocked.
And a nice steal by the Avs. Pass up ice. Coming in shorthanded. And Landeskog shielded from the puck. Both teams have had a shorthanded try, but denied. Koivu, he's got those 10 power play goals. He's out on the ice. Suter, pass in the middle, pass back, shot by Spurgeon, knocked down, and then Landeskog prevented Coyle from getting to the puck. Kept in by Suter, shoots wide of the net. Koivu will take it. So far, two shots on net for the Wild on this power play. But two great saves from Varlamov. Down low. Parise. Back up top for Suter. Parise, one timer, and Johnson blocked it for the Avalanche. 5 seconds to go in the penalty. Suter in, shot, another block. This time Mathias got in the way. Out of the box comes Bigras, long pass down the ice. And they're going to call icing on Colorado. But what a job there. First the saves by Varlamov and then the blocks.
Boy, Mike, there was, from my angle, there was just a lot of stuff going on. There's the first one. And remember, Vanek is a pure goal scorer. Here's Landeskog. Suter does a nice job of angling. It only gets sort of the one-hand backhand. But then Suter and Landeskog had a little match back behind the net. They had a couple of guys that might, they'll give you that little extra jab, both of them.
Still scoreless. We've crossed the halfway point of this one. Pauling, poke check from behind. Bigras snaps the puck to center. Scandella's got it. Avs making a change. Minnesota trying to take advantage of that. Shot hits wide of the net. Back to center ice. Pauling. Not a defenseman. Takes the puck. Makes the pass. Back to the middle and Holland flies in, and a nice job by Johnson to prevent him from getting a good shot. Johnson got his stick on Hollis' stick.
And that Hollis skate. Wow, because he was moving through that neutral zone.
Pass by Johnson. Shoots past Como. Icing called on the Avalanche.
Yeah, Mike. Holla, it's one of those things that, you know, you look at his numbers, Holla, and you know, when the season first started, he just couldn't get out of his own way. Four goals in the first 46 games. Like the last 23 games, he's had 8 goals, 11 assists, 19 points. It's sort of, you know, it's right in the same time, Mike, when the coaching changed. And you just have to wonder, just a little adjustment, a little more ice time, you know, just a different, you know, coach behind the bench can sometimes mean a difference to a player or two.
Parisi steals the puck away. Bounces back to the point. Jared Spurgeon lost it. And the Avalanche trying to come out of the zone, but it's turned over Parisi. Pass, far side, back in front, scored! Zach Parisi on a beautiful setup. And Minnesota has a 1-0 lead. It looked like the Wild had turned it over at their blue line, but they got it back and then turned it into a goal.
He just has the magic touch against the Avalanche. The Avs try to get a little tricky at their own blue line, Mike. But again, Parisi never quit on the play. A lot of guys would have made that pass, the one that Parisi makes, and watched it. Instead, what did he do? Watch him burst towards the net. And all of a sudden, Granlund, who broke the Avalanche hearts in that playoff series when he scored the overtime goal in game three. That was a nice play. You were positive that he was going to shoot, and he passed it.
Well, Minnesota scores the first goal of this tightly contested game. And Zach Parise on our key scoring summary with his 23rd goal of the season and fourth goal in the last five periods. And so the Minnesota Wild, with Granlund getting his 100th career assist, 11:27 of the period, lead by a score of 1-0. Again, moving in, pass comes across, Barry got a man in front, and then the shot went wide. Barry turns and shoots off the side of the Minnesota net. Crowd exploded when they saw that the netting moving, but it hit the side of it. Scramble behind the net. Still free and given back to the Avalanche. Redmond kicks the puck to the corner for Mitchell. Back up the boards, and the puck slithers out to center. Shot in around, slowed up by Dubnyk. Scandella for Minnesota. The center, shoots the puck in. Stopped behind the net by Varlamov. Bigrov rams it around the boards. Skilly, center ice. McLeod, one hands it to the corner. Rantanen for the Avalanche. Squeezed against the wall in the corner by Dumba. And the Wild make a quick pass to Spring Riley. He skates over the line for the trailer. Trader turns, shoots, and Varlamov came out of the net, way out of the net, to stop that one. Well, he made a big save there, but there was nothing he could do on Zach Parise scoring the goal.
14 games. That means 28 of the 30 clubs have played today. Only New Jersey and Vancouver don't. But what's really interesting, shows you the parity of the National Hockey League, there's only one game that has no playoff implications at all. There are five games where both teams are fighting for playoff spots or positioning, and 8 games, Mike, where one team is playing and the other has nothing in, you know, to work for, sort of thing. Interesting to watch those games. But look at the Western Conference. It was 88 for a month and a half, and now all of a sudden it's crept up to 91, which for the Colorado Avalanche, Mike, means, including tonight's game, they probably need to go at least 6-2.
Right now, trailing Minnesota 1-0 in the second period. Granlund against Mitchell. And Mitchell wins another faceoff. He is 5-1 in faceoffs in this game. Puck sails over the glass out of play. Burke Simpson reminds you that when the game is on the line, call 303-792-5595. Burke Simpson, good lawyers, changing lives.
And just to finish off a thought on the NHL and sort of the scheduling, 16 days remaining in the National Hockey League. It's 102 games remaining included today. After tonight, 104, pardon me, they'll be down to 90 games left in this NHL season.
Well, there was an extra day tacked on, right,
Peter? Exactly.
Because of snow outs and the games involving, I think, Washington and Anaheim. It'll be a game that'll be played after the Avalanche play the Ducks for the last regular season game for the Avalanche. Ducks will have to go to Washington to play that game against the Capitals on Monday. The puck comes behind. Go ahead, Peter. I'm sorry.
And Philadelphia plays the New York Islanders two games.
That could have some big implications.
Exactly. I mean, both those games could be really important in the standings.
Riley, 360s, put the puck out in front of the net, and comes free for the Avalanche to take. Mitchell makes the pass, blocked by the Wild. Coyle back to the point, shot around behind the net, comes up the wing. Suter pitches in to the half boards, loses the puck. Barry got it, center ice for Mitchell. Chased down by Parisi, able to shoot the puck into the Minnesota end. Pass to the corner for Spurgeon. Lead pass to center. Garrett in, a nice move by Koivu. Goes wide. Sends it up the boards. Mathias pushes out to center ice. A little pressure from behind by Parisi. Long pass through center. But Wild were making a change, so there's no connection on the pass. Boschman, long try for Mathias. It was tipped, so no icing. Play continues on. Much behind the net. Suter and Spurgeon there for Minnesota. Mathias and Soderberg for Colorado, but the puck comes to center. Degro, quick pass for Landeskog. Forced back into the Minnesota zone. Makes the pass back for Degro. Up ice, Holden. Pass slowed up. Slammed from center ice back in by the Wild. Varlamov sends it around. Tip free. Avalanche has got it. Grigorenko's pass to center. Blocked in the middle circle. Wild have the puck. Quick pass over the line. Pominville's shot misses wide. Niederreiter put the puck behind the net for Pominville. Pollock to Pominville. Pass in front. Niederreiter was looking the wrong way.
So was Parlin.
Degrom bounced the puck in. Dubnyk put the puck up the board, but Bodker chasing. Stole, can't stay with him. Bodker dropped at the point, shot by Boschman, got blocked. Fontaine skates to center. Across the red line, able to dump it in. Stole giving chase. Tangled up behind the net. Stole moves it off the boards, back to the point. Dumba turns and shoots, but Boschman got in the way. Leads the abs in block shots. Got another one from the point. Dumba gave it away to Bodker. Quick pass up Bites, and a nice one for Skilly, but Dumba stole it. And the Wild on the move. Granlund, pass over the line. Onside, Riley to Granlund. And the puck turned up the boards, but the defenseman Riley was deep in the zone. So the Avalanche trying to get it up the ice, had it come off the skate of Skilly behind the Minnesota net. Pressure from Rantanen. But Dumba, quick pass for Riley. Pass up ice, tipped by Vanek. Towards the corner, puck squirts straight. Avs have got it. Blake Como for Colorado. Sends it up and out of the zone. Lands in the neutral zone. Pass tipped ahead by Jones. Johnson for the Avalanche. See what the big defenseman does here. He's got some room. Likes to make a pass right up the middle for Mitchell. Skates to Como. His pass broken up quickly up the ice for the Wild. Carried through the middle. Coyle coming in. Parisi down the middle. Shot saved by Varlamov. He was able to direct the puck wide. The Wild were charging the front of the net. Pass to Parisi. Back to Coyle to the corner for Koivu. One hands it up the boards, or Holden did for Colorado, but didn't get it out of the zone. Spurgeon from the point. Shot blocked in front of the net. Back up the point. Spurgeon. Looking as the puck shot in around to by Mitchell. Landeskog reversed it back behind the net. Coming up the near side, charging in is Boschman. And the Avalanche with the puck shot. Mitchell takes it along the wing. Pass stolen. Bounced out to center ice. Hooked back the other way. Mitchell for Colorado at the blue line. Koivu, quick pass to center ice for Jared Spurgeon. And didn't get a lot on it as he dumps the puck in. And it rolled on his stick. Puck behind the net. Pass comes in front. And tipped just in time by the Avs. Kipped in by Scandella. Hooked the puck back behind the net. Beauchemin. Nice move to step away from trouble. Gets the pass of Bice for Soderberg. Abs on the move. Soderberg's pass stolen away. And a breakaway chance for Niederreiter. Oh, what a save by Varlamov. What a save. Huge save again by Varlamov. Those are those saves when you look back at the end of this game. The Avalanche can win this, but remember that save. Shut around the boards, back to center ice. Tipped in, we're in the final minute of the period. Botker gets a pass. All of a sudden, it's the Wild who've been relentless, Peter, going after the puck.
Oh, yeah, this has been a little bit of a turnaround in this period. They're in a nice rhythm right now, the Wild.
But the Avs steal it back. Lifted in, Rodin with Varlamov. Peter, what a save that was.
You know, as we said, there's going to be big moments, and that was one of them.
That was. Pass in front, tip, scored. That one wasn't. For the Avalanche, it was for the Minnesota Wild, and Schrader tips in the puck with less than 22 seconds to go in the period. It's 2-0 for Minnesota.
Yeah, 22 seconds. This is their 22nd shot. I was looking to see maybe. Look, Mike, what a nice play. He felt Varlamov coming across. He knew he couldn't put it directly in. He just chipped that one up and over. What great hands on that play. Nice pass. No question about it, but he just chips it up and over.
Well, just moments after sensational save from Varlamov on Niederreiter's breakaway. The Wild then get a goal from Schrader. We're down the last 2 seconds of the period. Oh, a penalty called.
Yeah. Oh, Mike, we're at
on the Avalanche.
Yeah, we're at a critical point in this hockey game right now.
Number 27.
I don't know what's going to happen in these last 9 seconds, but Minnesota starts the third period with either a 3-0 lead or a 2-0 lead with a power play. And so the Colorado Avalanche are going to have to, I mean, they're going to kill this one off and then get back to the way they were in that first period.
Andreas Martinsson for hooking at 19:50. Wild with the faceoff, shot and the save made. Shot by Spurgeon, another save. Koivu with a chance and another save at the buzzer. Varlamov actually had to make some saves there in the last few seconds of the period. But Minnesota with goals from Parisi and Schrader. Peter, they lead 2-0 over the Avs.
They had a terrific period. Dubnyk, I mean, made a couple of saves, but there's just no question they had a much better second period. You know, they were the ones that were chasing the pucks down, and the Avalanche turnover in that first goal right at the blue line, those will always kill you. So the Avs have to kill this one off now, Mike, and get going in this hockey game offensively.
Well, the referees, linesmen in today's game between the Avalanche and the Minnesota Wild, wearing number 12, the letters BM standing for Butch Mousseau, who recently passed away, a referee local, and very sad news. More on that. Here is Julie Brown.
Thanks, Mike. Well, everyone at Altitude would like to pass on their thoughts and condolences to the family of hockey referee Butch Mousseau, who passed away yesterday from a head injury he suffered in a fall to the ice before a WCHA Final Five game last weekend. Now, the Erie, Colorado native was well-known and well-liked throughout the hockey community in Colorado and across the country. He's survived by his wife and 3 children. If you would like to help, you can donate at GoFundMe.com or DogNation.com. Butch Mousseau was only 48 years old when he passed away. We'll be right back.
Avalanche go to the third period trailing 2-0, and Peter, Minnesota has some power play time that carries over from the second period.
Yeah, and for the Colorado Avalanche now, they have gone 9 games and 2 periods of perfect penalty killing. They have to kill this one.
And Peter, just a small note, the Avalanche, as Derek Johnson gets the puck to Como. He shoots it wide. Avalanche trailing by two, but Peter, they've been among the leaders this season in terms of trailing by two, but coming back in those games to win. Parisi, pass to Coyle. Over the line, Coyle has the puck, but we got a whistle. Oh, was there a penalty away from the play?
It wasn't really away from the play. Coyle bounced the puck off the boards, and then he took Soderberg's feet out from under him. So, Mike, not a big break, but certainly.
Minor penalty for chipping.
That's exactly what the Avalanche wanted. What will they end up, Mike? They'll get about 33 seconds of power play time at the end of this 4-on-4 situation. That is huge.
So it is Coyle for tripping at 24 seconds. Minnesota 0-for-2 today on the power play. As Peter pointed out, Avs will get some power play time as we go 4-on-4 hockey. Landeskog coming out of the corner. Darting around. Still with the puck is Landeskog. Still with it. Towards the blue line. Still with the puck, but then it came out of the zone. Shot in, offside, Colorado.
Well, you have to know that Patrick Waugh was not pleased with that second period. Mike, you know, you hate to look at numbers, but they jump right out at you. That's 37 shots on goal. 37 in the second period against Philadelphia, combined with the shot tonight. Philadelphia had 20 in that second period. So, Mike, that's just a lot of shots on goal. The Avalanche have got to turn around and get that same intensity, because Minnesota's back on their heels in that first period, and they got into a groove in the second.
Rodin to the red line, into the Colorado zone. By himself along the boards. Elects to send it behind the net, where he gets cut off by Barry. Tyson Barry gives the puck to Iginla. 45 seconds remaining in Martinson's penalty. And then some power play time for the Avalanche. Coming in is Mitchell. Barry goes to the front of the net. And the pass deflects. Pominville pulls up and waits. Sends it back for Granlund. A little pressure from Iginla. Still a minute left to go in the penalty on Coyle. Playing 4-on-4. Brodin loses the puck. A little support from Koivu. Played out to center. Pressure by the Avalanche. They get Minnesota to turn the puck over. Soderberg over the line. Puck tipped up high in the air. Koivu's got it. And now it's power play time for the Avalanche. Out of the box is Martinson. And a whistle. Where are they going to put the face off? They're going to put it at center ice.
Yep. I was watching the play behind where Soderberg ran into Dubnyk, and he was a little upset. I think Dubnyk, but he had been knocked down, Soderberg had, and knocked into him. So the referee quickly came over to sort of make sure that the goaltender understood that.
So 28 seconds of power play time for the Avalanche. Avs' last shot on goal was with 6:18 remaining in the second period. No shots in the last 8 minutes, 15 seconds for the Avalanche. But they do have some power play time. Now 20 seconds left to go in this power play. Barry, with some speed, drops it behind him for Bodker. Gets it to Landeskog, stolen away. And Minnesota, going to push the puck ahead. There's going to be another penalty on Minnesota. Another penalty on the wild. I think Fontaine's going to get another penalty.
Like the same kind of penalty that he got in the first period, where he just grabbed the arm of the guy.
Didn't need to, Peter.
Oh, no. They absolutely didn't need to.
Otherwise, Peter Martin, all in.
It's just one of those ones, Mike, where you're just trying to do a little bit too much. There he just catches him, pulls him around. The referee's right there. You see the arm go up.
Holding is the penalty at 2:27. 4th power play chance of the game for the Avalanche. Iginla Right-handed shot. We'll try to win that faceoff. Barry's sitting back behind him. And the puck comes to Koivu. Slapped it out of the zone. Justin Fontaine. So Fontaine's second penalty of the game. Seconds of the third period. He sits in the box. The Avalanche on the power play. Barry gets in. Still with the puck. Dyson Barry up the boards. And Holland took a hit from McGinley, but able to deliver the puck back into the Avalanche zone. Bodker for the Avalanche. Weaving his way through. Sends a nice pass over the line for Grigorenko. Back to Bodker. Gets checked. Puck poked free. Back for Ginlett. Stolen away and cleared out. Grigorenko, excuse me, had an opportunity there, but the Wild able to clear it out. Buried up Bice. Right through the middle by Ginlett. Puck stolen away. Cleared out again by the Wild.
They're reading everything perfectly. There seems to be a Minnesota Wild player in exactly the right position on every pass the Avalanche make.
Como makes the pass. Soderberg back to the point for Boschman. Greasy got in the way and able to slip the puck. Pass Boschman out of the zone. 35 seconds left to go. In the penalty on Fontaine. Soderberg. Puck wound around. Brunin tipped the puck. Got it out of the zone. Penalty on the Avalanche. Mathias, delay call. Granlund makes the pass. Paula has the puck. Paula's pass tipped by the Avs out to center. Should be a penalty on Colorado. Mathias is going in the box. The Avs did not get a shot on net during that power play opportunity. Still 14 seconds left in Fontaine's penalty. As Mathias gets called for hooking.
And Mike, isn't it interesting? You go on the power play and there's that energy that builds up in the anticipation. And sometimes it can work against you. It's kind of like when the power play is over and it hasn't worked, you're kind of like, you know, you drop a little bit. And so it's taken some of the steam out of the Avalanche on the various power plays that they've had.
But the Avs penalty killer. They've 27 in a row here on home ice. 49 of 51. Killing penalties. Shot to the point, blocked in front of the net. Avalanche pick it up as Mathias in the box. Going 4-on-4. Mitchell brings the puck in. Handed off to Boschman. Chopped away from him. Picked up, carried to center ice. Fontaine's out of the box. Is now a power play chance for a minute and 46 seconds for Minnesota. Turned around for Koivu. To the point. Ryan Suter. Finds Parisi. Back to Suter. Looking for an opening. Parisi shoots, scores! Zach Parisi, a power play goal, makes it 3-0 for Minnesota, his second goal of the game. We talked about who would be difference makers this afternoon, Peter, and Zach Parisi has come to play and delivered.
Did he snap that one? I had a great angle of him wanting the puck. And when it comes over, nice pass by Suter. That'll be Suter. Look at that shot, Michael. I didn't see, I mean, I was on this side, so I didn't see the angle of that shot. What a shot by Parise. And that is, I mean, he couldn't have walked towards the net and placed it inside of the net any better than that. Wow. Now that's 5 goals in a couple of games here in Colorado this year.
5 goals in the last 2 games for him, yeah. Peter. He had a hat trick against Calgary. In his last game, he's got 2 in this one. And Minnesota leading 3-0. Here's your power back rehabilitation scoring summary. Parisi's second of the game, 24th of the season on the power play from Suter and Koivu. And your power back rehabilitation scoring summary. Shows that Minnesota now with a 3-0 lead.
And Mike, what does this do to change the strategy? Well, for Minnesota, what it does, now, you're rolling 4 lines and all 6 defensemen, 3 pairs of defensemen. So you're gonna have fresh bodies on the ice all the time. Smart plays in front of the puck, just really make the Avalanche work for anything that they're going to get. For the Avs, they just got to go. You just got to go completely to the wall on every shift.
Well, that goal by Parise, making 3-0, as I mentioned. Suter picked up an assist. That gives him 400 points in his career. The Avs are called for icing.
Well, Torchetti's come in, Mike, and just, he obviously has had the right things to say. And they're set, Mike, I think the thing that's really improved, or one of the things that's really improved, they're 7-3-1 on the road coming into this game. So at home, they've been good. On the road, they've been really good.
Granlund dancing along the line, centering pass. Slipped up the slot in the Wild. Kept it in. Back down the boards to the half boards. Bigrod. Pass in front of his net for Rantanen. Skating out to center. Boy, would the Avs like to reverse what Minnesota did to Colorado in that first game of the season. Shot by Barry, whistled wide. 3-goal lead for the Avalanche for the third period. And then the Wild came back to win that game. Martinson shoots, and Dubnyk holds the puck against his chest for the faceoff. Parise on the power play for the Minnesota Wild. His second goal of the afternoon, 3-0 Wild.
21 years old, originally drafted by the New Jersey Devils. Signed what everyone knows was a gigantic contract with the Minnesota Wild. But he is that kind of player that when you watch him play, like, there's an energy about him. And he works for everything. I mean, that first goal, Mike, he broke past, he jumped into the hole. The second one was just skipped. Just a fabulous shot up over the shoulder. Semi Varlamov, who was screened on the play, really had no chance. One, because he was screened. Two, was a perfect shot.
Peter, when you play with players like that, and I know that you have, it would seem to be, is it contagious?
Oh, of course. I mean, you feed off your best players being that kind of player.
We'll have another penalty.
You know what the Minnesota Wild are saying right now, Mike? It's nail in the coffin time.
Yep. One more goal and that'll be it.
Yep. And so
now Mikhail Botker into the penalty box. Go ahead, Peter. I'm sorry.
No, no problem. With 5 power play goals the last 3 games, this is a confident group jumping on the ice for the Minnesota Wild. And then the thing was, Mike, and you know when things go bad, they go really bad. All the top players from Minnesota were rested for a couple of shifts and are rested right now coming on the power play.
4th power play chance of the game for Minnesota. They are 1-for-3. Shot! And Varlamov did not allow a rebound. Coyle was hoping that puck would come free, but it did not. Get in the driver's seat of a rugged Kia Sorento. It's the perfect getaway vehicle. You can visit your Kia dealer or go to ColoradoKiaDealers.com to learn more. Another win on the draw for Minnesota. Pass over to Spurgeon. Into the near faceoff circle for Koivu. Back up top. Suter. Gets the puck back from Spurgeon. Shot through a lot of traffic. Save, rebound. And it is underneath Varlamov. Nice save.
Ryan Suter, number 20 for the Minnesota Wild, is having his best offensive season. 8 goals, now 41 assists. Mike, he's been on the ice for all 3 of the goals that the Minnesota Wild have scored today. And, you know, you underscored the fact that he just doesn't seem to come off. But he's so smart about when he does come off. Because his main thing to do in this situation is be on the ice in the defensive zone. So when the play is coming up the ice, he'll jump off and let somebody go up and be in the offensive zone. So when they come back, coming back towards Minnesota's zone, then he jumps back on the ice.
As I mentioned earlier, he picked up his 400th point in his career. So not just all about defense. He certainly has done his offensive work. Shot by Suter, got blocked. Puck comes back to him. Pull it across for Spurgeon. Over to Koivu. Pass in the middle. Tip back towards Koivu. Suter steps in, makes the pass. Burton shoots, blocked. Burton keeps it alive for a moment, and it's cleared out by the Avalanche. Dubnyk will set it up at the side of the net. A couple of shots on this power play for Minnesota. Granlund gets it over the line with a nifty pass. Niederreiter back to Riley at the blue line. Vanek cutting in. Dropped it for Granlund. To Vanek. Got knocked away from the puck. And brought to center by Soderberg. Cuts through the slot. Still with it is Soderberg. And his shot hit a skate. Bounced behind the Minnesota net. 20 seconds left to go in Bakker's penalty. Dump it to the red line. For a trailer. Saucer pass across. Slammed around. Dropped in the corner. Puck kick free. Wild have it. Pass the far circle for Dumba. Landeskog on him. One-handed behind the net. Penalty is done. Bakker's out of the box. Two shots total on the power play for Minnesota. But they did not put another nail in the coffin. For the Avalanche. And then three. Puck thrown away. Pass up the center. Fontaine. Skeets in. Backhands it wide of the net. And the Wild. Momentville. Chipped it to the corner. At 11 minutes to go in the third period. Puck lifted to center. Mitchell. Stripped away. Holland. Long pass. Tipped in by Pominville of Minnesota. And the puck behind the net. Slammed around. Candela shoots, misses. Found glass. And the puck comes out to center. Rodin. The cross for Fontaine to take. Gets the puck in from center ice. So I'm going to call icing on Minnesota.
Just watching the Minnesota bench right now. As we expected. It started in the second period, Mike, for the Minnesota Wild. They started to get into a 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4 rhythm on the ice. It eventually led to, you know, the two goals that they did score. But they were coming, you know, with a nice wave at the Avalanche. And the Avalanche, just a couple of shifts that didn't work out for them. And that late goal was a big one for the Minnesota Wild.
Because Peter came right after Varlamov made that sensational save on the breakaway.
Exactly.
And so, we've seen that formula so many times, right?
Exactly.
He makes the big save, gives you a chance to come back. But then that goal happens, Peter pointed out. Seemed to change things.
Yeah, 1-0 going into the third period when you're a club that has come back, as the Avalanche have. They come back in a lot of games. But 2-0 all of a sudden, because this Minnesota Wild club is playing really good hockey right now. They're a confident club. And
Peter Varlamov is going to the bench.
Well, Patrick is going for it.
Wow, is he ever. 10 minutes and 21 seconds to go in the third period. Down 3-0, and Patrick Waugh has put Varlamov on the bench for an extra skater with a faceoff in the Minnesota zone.
In fact, there's a couple reasons. One, the Avalanche aren't generating much offense. Nope. And so you have to do something. You have to absolutely do something. Just get this started for the Avalanche.
Try to get it ignited. Try to get the crowd back into it. Try to get your bench excited. And the Avalanche have pulled the goaltender. This season, the Avalanche have given up 14 empty net goals, including one the other night against the Philadelphia Flyers. Pass in front, and it just slid by Gidler. Brought down the near side by Johnson. Back up top for Martinson. His shot deflected. Goes all the way down the ice. Minnesota changing things up. Avalanche changing up as well. Again, six skaters for the Avalanche. We're halfway through the third period. Varlamov has gone back into the net. And the puck comes into the near side. So that took place while the face after. Oh, penalty on Koivu. Avs are going to get a power play chance. Now Varlamov's got to skate again to the net. Get an extra guy out there. Boschman makes the pass. Bakker, hand off. Barry sends it across. Shot wide of the net. The Avalanche still in possession. Delay penalty on Minnesota. Shot up high off the glass and touched by the Wild. So Koivu with a trip on Landeskog behind the net is going to the penalty box. There's the penalty. And the Avalanche get a power move. Which player has the fastest hat trick in NHL history? The answer, Bill Mozienko. Congratulations. Frank, you are today's winner. You've also qualified to win a car at the end of the season, courtesy of Stevenson Automotive.
21 seconds, but they all came in the third period. The 7-6 win by the Chicago Blackhawks over the New York Rangers. 6:09, 6:20, and 6:31, I believe, or 6:30 were the times of those three goals. All of even strength.
So the Avalanche could use three goals.
Yes.
They have the
power
play.
Where's Bill now, Mike? Where's Bill now?
Well, with Varlamov on the bench, it's a 6-on-4 situation for the Avalanche. Two-man advantage for Minnesota, with the Wild win the faceoff. Weird out to center ice. A little pressure. Granlund to the empty net. He scores! And that might be it. 8:54 to go. Mikhail Granlund, who made that great pass to set up the first goal of this game, just scored an empty netter. That's the 15th empty net goal of the season against the Avalanche.
Well, the Avalanche just, the puck was bouncing a little bit. Granlund, you should have seen the facial expressions that he had. It was like, the puck just came to me, and he just, you know, he just buries it.
Four nothing for Minnesota. And folks are heading for the exits here at Pepsi Center. Coaches are going on, they're heading out of the building. Down 4-0. McGinley with the puck at the line. Still dancing, but they've got away. Pass across for Landeskog. McGinley. Taken down by Spurgeon. A lot of players along that half wall digging for the puck. By the way, Varlamov back in net for the Avalanche after that empty netter made it 4-0. They're still on a power play though. Fifth of the game. Shot to the corner. Ginla leads the team with 12 power play goals. Pass across, got tipped by Stoll. Bounced up the boards. Barry flipped it across for Bodker to take. Side of the net, pass in front, blocked between the circles, cleared out by Minnesota. The linesman Von Rode jumping up in the air to get out of the way of that clear out by Minnesota. They have so far with one shot on goal in this power play opportunity. Cross ice pass for Boston. Shot around the boards, cut off. And it bounced off of Johnson, and the puck lands in the Minnesota bench. Today's game is being brought to you in part by your friends at Jack Daniels, who remind you to drink responsibly. ...21 seconds left in the Koivu penalty, 7:24 to go in the game. Minnesota leading 4-0. Cross ice pass, scooped up by Como. Pass brought in by Mathias. He shoots, broke his stick on the shot. Pass in front for Como, missed it. Pass to center for Koivu, just came out of the penalty box. So the Avalanche with one shot during that power play chance, 0-for-5 today. That's the team that came in ranked 27th in the league, killing penalties.
Well, Mike, one of our keys that we had in tonight's game was specialty teams and stop Parisi. Well, Parisi's got a couple of goals, and Minnesota's got a power play goal and killed off 5.
So what you're saying is you knew exactly what was going to happen.
No, they were keys. You know, and because Parisi, he was on a big slump. I think he had 2 goals in 27 games.
Correct, right.
And, you know, that's not Zach Parisi. So when he had got lifted all that weight off his shoulders with the hat trick, and now all of a sudden he's just playing loose, and he's flying tonight.
Pass in front, saved by Dubnyk. Puck lands on the back of the Minnesota net, flipped over towards Barry. 6 minutes to go. Pass shot by Rantanen off the heel of his stick going wide. And a steal away from Redmond. Niederreiter, Hammondville going to the net. Niederreiter sneaking behind. Collides with Skilly. And the puck to the blue line. Scandella passed. Goes wide on the net. Back to the blue line. Kept in by Brodin. Backhanded. Sent around into the far corner for Granlund. He took a hard hit from Barry. And the puck to center. Barry skates in. Dropped it. Back to Barry. Circles. Threw it out in front. Chance for Martinson, but couldn't get the shot away. Vigra kicks the puck to Mitchell. Pass between the circles, taken away, carried to center. Got in wide of the net, angles in front. Varlamov trying to clear, bounced off of David Jones and back to center. And less than 5 minutes to go in this game for Minnesota. They're going to get to 85 points and a 5-point lead over the Avalanche. Avs will have 7 games remaining. 6 left for Minnesota.
And Michael, stranger things have happened, certainly. But now the Avalanche for sure are going to need help. And so you've had it in your hands, and now you're going to need some help from various clubs that Minnesota Wild are going to play against.
The Avalanche will play Monday and Tuesday. Both Central Division games coming up. Nashville on Monday, St. Louis on Tuesday. And then, a nice, how do you do? You come back after that trip, Peter, and you got to play the best team in the National Hockey League, the Washington Capitals, on Friday.
They've been the most impressive club we've played this year. The Avalanche have played this year, I thought, in the game that they played. They were.
Agree with you 100%, Peter.
I mean, Holtby wasn't even that good that night. And they didn't need him to be. Their defense was solid. They're deep. They've got balanced lines. They are really, this could be an interesting year for the Washington Capitals.
One of the keys for that coach is you got to keep their interest going down the stretch here, right?
They haven't been playing all that well up late. But, you know, it's one of those things that, you know, you've seen it just too often. You can't try and just turn it on.
3 minutes left to go in this one. Minnesota up 4-0. Minnesota's going to take this season series, winning 4 of the 5 games this year. Well, they've done the job against the Avalanche, also the Chicago Blackhawks, too, this season. They played very well, Minnesota has, against Chicago. Backhanded by Scandella. Skilly takes that long rebound, skates through center. Pass to McLeod, backhand save made by Dubnyk. And we'll return with more of the third period in Denver. 4-0 Minnesota.
Here it is, Michael. And just for the fans, you see where Nashville has 89 points and San Jose has 88. And yet San Jose is in the playoffs and Nashville is just a wild card. Remember, the top 3 clubs in each division make it into the playoffs. Doesn't matter what the points are. The top 3 clubs in the Central, top 3 clubs in the Pacific. And then it's the next 2 clubs according to points.
Nashville, the next opponent for the Avalanche on Monday in Nashville. Well, after coming back following a 3-game winning streak through Canada, feeling good about themselves, the Avalanche, a devastating, heartbreaking loss on Thursday to Philadelphia. Game in which they had the lead in the third period, only to lose it in regulation, and then this afternoon against Minnesota. A couple of losses here at home. Avalanche going to go to 17-17-4 on home ice. Varlamov plays the puck ahead. Jones slides it down the board in front of the net for Granlund. Going to make a pass. Rantanen picked it off. 2 minutes to go in the game.
Mike, certainly is not an excuse. Every team runs through injuries, but you did know at some time that the injuries to McKinnon and Duchesne were going to have take a toll in some area, and you got to wonder if tonight that wasn't that power play for the Avalanche, where they couldn't have used those two guys.
The Avalanche team, Peter, that much this season have not been injury-riddled.
No.
But coming at a very difficult time, losing both McKinnon and Duchesne. Penalty on Martinson. With 1:24 left to go in the game. So Minnesota's going to get a late power play with Martinson's second penalty of the game.
Watch how strong. Dumba is a really strong guy. And Martinson just threw him down. I mean, and that's just I'm going to be really interested, Mike, to see what kind of player he becomes next year. Martinson, he's going to have a whole year of working out NHL facilities, you know, getting his body ready, and because this is his first year over in North America, and he has, over the course of the last few games, had some tremendous moments for the Avalanche. That assist he had on Mitchell's goal the other night, that was fantastic.
And he just would not be denied, so terrible. But it's a holding penalty. Minnesota on the power play, save made by Varlamov.
Mike, there's the frightening thing. He's just 25 years old, so he's, you know, he's going to get bigger. There's just a beautiful goal. Here's another nice goal. This was against Vancouver, made it 3-1. And then the play the other night, I mean, that was just great hands, good vision. But again, it's the idea, Mike, that he's going to get me stronger.
You're not going to want to shake his hand, dude.
It'd be like Scott Parker. Right. You used to shake Scott Parker's hand and say, Scott, I'll take a hug. I want my hand. I got to be able to write.
Well, in the last minute of this game, Minnesota with a power play chance. Martinson sits in the box. Centered in front. Chance. That gets blocked. Tipped to the corner. Pominville. 40 seconds to go in the game. Cross-ice pass for Dumba. Missed it. Riley behind the net. Dumba shoots. They made by Varlamov. Puck popped up in the air. Pass across. So far, three shots in this power play for Minnesota. Hand off to Pominville. Shot missed by Dumba. Side of the net. Pominville shot and right against the post. Varlamov makes the save.
You know, Mike, it's interesting. This is what respect does. Perschetti, Mike, you know what he didn't do? He didn't throw the big boys out in this power play. He's given the third and fourth line guys an opportunity.
Peter, what happened there with Varlamov?
He was handing something to the referee. I'm not sure what.
Something skate out there, and then the linesman. Puck gets tipped out. So there's Varlamov. Three goals against. There was also an empty netter on the other side for Devan Dubnyk this afternoon. In his fifth season, 19th career shutout. Peter, it's the third time he has shut out the Colorado Avalanche. His career.
Yeah, I believe now, Mike, it reads the last 10 games between these two clubs, 8-1-1 for the Minnesota Wild and 5 shutouts. So, you know, they found their way against the Avs.
In big games.
Yes.
They did that in Minnesota. They did that here this afternoon and 2 years ago in Game 7 as Devan Dubnyk celebrates his 19th career shutout. Zach Parise with 2 goals to lead the way for the Minnesota Wild offensively. And the Minnesota Wild now with 5 points ahead of the Avalanche in that race for the final playoff spot in the Western Conference. 4-0.